I already discussed about the performance of transmission line in previous classes. Now in today's lesson, my topic of discussion is on the analysis of the long transmission line. So the performance of transmission line is totally based on three elements. That means any transmission line has three parameters like R, L and C distributed uniformly along with the whole length of the line. The resistance and the inductance makes the series impedance, whereas the capacitance developed between the two conductors and connected in parallel with the two lines. So the capacitance effect is introduced the complications in transmission lines parameters for calculations. So according to the length of the transmission line, the parameters of the lines are classified into three category. Like first one is the short transmission line, second one is the medium transmission line, and third one is the long transmission line. So when the length of the transmission line is below 50 km, whereas the working voltage is greater than 20 kV, so this type of transmission line is classed as the short transmission line. And when the length of the transmission line in between 50 km to 150 km and the working voltage is in between 20 kV to 100 kV, this type of transmission line is called the medium transmission lines. And the long transmission line is defined when the length of the transmission line is more than 150 km, whereas the working voltage is greater than 100 kV. So these are called the long transmission lines. So now in today's class, my topic of discussion is on the analysis of the long transmission line. So these are the equivalent circuit of a three-phase long transmission lines, where this section is the sending end section, which is connected with the power station or power generating station, and these are the receiving end station, which is connected with the load. Here the voltage at the sending end is called the Vs and the voltage at the receiving end called the Vr. So these are the resistance and inductive reactance, and this is the sending end current is denoted by Is, and this is the receiving end current denoted by Ir, and these are the parameters, and this is the capacitance, which is connected in parallel with the internal resistance. So this, now in the above figure, in this figure shows the equivalent circuit of a three phase transmission line on a phase neutral basis. The whole line is divided into n number of sections, each section having a line constant of 1 by nth of this of the whole lines, and the following factors are vital for analysis of long transmission line. First point, the line constant are uniformly distributed over the entire length of the line. But we know practically the line parameters like resistance, inductance and capacitance are not uniformly distributed throughout the long transmission line, because you already know that the long transmission line is very large, that is above 150 km length. So that is not possible to uniform distribution of the parameters, and these parameters are varies due to the area, due to the sag and due to the others parameters. So this is not possible to distribution uniformly, but practically for simple calculation we always can consider the parameters of the transmission lines are uniformly distributed throughout the line. Next point, the resistance and inductive reactance are connected in series. So these are the resistance and these are the inductive reactance. The in whole network, this resistance and inductance reactance are connected in series with the circuit. And the leakage susceptance B and the leakage conductance G are the shunt element. So therefore admittance equals to root over of G square by B square. Next point, the leakage current to the shunt admittance is maximum at sending end and the line, and decreases continuously as the receiving end of the circuit is approached, at which the point of its value is zero. Now the main analysis of the transmission line with the help of rigorous methods. So this is the equivalent circuit. This portion, this left portion is the sending end, which is connected with the power station, and this is the receiving end connected to the load center. So in this section, Z is the series impedance of the line for unit length, and this z equals to r plus jx, where r is the real part and x is the imaginary part, are known as the resistance and the reactance of the line per unit length respectively. And y is the shunt admittance of the line per unit length. Here V is the voltage per phase at the end of the element towards the receiving end. I is the current entering to the element. So this is the element, this is the I which is connect to the, which is passing to the load. And V plus dV, so this voltage is called the V plus dV, and this voltage is equals to the voltage per phase at the end of the element towards the sending ends. So the this is, so the voltage near to the sending end portion is V denoted by V plus dV, and VR and IR are the voltage per phase at the sending end and the receiving end respectively. IR and IR, IS and IR are the current per phase at the sending end and receiving end respectively. So this current is the sending end current and this current is the receiving end current. Now the for the small elements dx, z dx equals to series impedance and y dx equals to shunt admittance. Now obviously the rise in voltage over the element length in direction of increasing x. So dv equals to I into z dx. So dv by dx equals to I z. So this is called equation number 1. Similarly, the difference of current entering the element and that of the leaving the element is I plus di minus I, that is equals to di. So di equals to vy dx. So from this equation we can write di by dx equals to vy, and this expression is called the equation number 2. Now the differentiating equation 1 with respect to the x, we can write d2v by dx2 equals to z di by dx, and that is equals to zyv, because from the previous equation we know that di by dx equals to voy, or d2v by dx2 minus zyv equals to 0, that is equation number 3. Now the solution of the equation is v equals to k1 exponential of root into root over of yz into x plus k2 exponential of under bracket minus of root over of yz into x, and that is equation number 4. Now from equation number 1 and 4 we can consider zc equals to root over of z into y, and the gamma equals to root over of y into z, and that is equals to alpha plus j beta, where alpha is the real part and beta is the imaginary part, and this is equation number 5, where zc is known as the characteristic impedance and the gamma is called the propagation constant. Now the equation 4 and 5 and the rewritten as v equals to ki e to the power gamma x plus k2 e to the power minus of gamma x. So I equals to 1 by zc into k into under bracket k1 e to the power gamma x minus k2 e to the power minus of gamma x. So this is called the equation number 7, and the previous equation is equation 6. Now I equals to dv by dx into 1 by z, and that is equals to 1 by z gamma into under bracket k1 e to the power gamma x minus k2 e to the power minus of gamma x. So if we can solve the equation, then the answer is root over of yz by z divided by root over yz by z into k1 e to the power gamma x minus k2 e to the power minus of gamma x, and that is equals to root over of y by z into under bracket k1 e to the power gamma x minus k2 e to the power minus of gamma x, and that is equals to 1 by Zc into k1 e to the power gamma x minus k2 e to the power minus of gamma x. Now, the two constants k1 and k2 are to be determined and hence two boundary conditions should be known. So, first one is that at the receiving end where x equals to 0 and second the v equals to vr and I equals to ir. So, these are the consideration. Now, substituting this value of equation 6 and 7 we get vr equals to k1 plus k2 and ir equals to 1 by zc into under bracket k1 minus k2. So therefore k1 equals to vr plus ir zc divided by 2 and similarly k2 equals to vr minus ir zc divided by 2. Now substituting the value of k1 and k2 in equation 6 and 7 we get v1 equals to vr plus ir zc by 2 into e to the power gamma x plus vr minus ir zc by 2 into e to the power minus gamma x, that is equation number 8. So here I equals to 1 by zc into under bracket vr plus ir zc by 2 e to the power gamma x plus vr IRZC VR minus IRZC by 2 into e to the power minus of gamma x. So this is equation number 9. Now expanding and rearranging the equation number 8 and 9 we get V equals to VR into e to the power gamma x plus e to the power minus of gamma x by 2 plus IR into ZC into under bracket e to the power gamma x minus e to the power minus of gamma x divided by 2. So, from this equation, we can write V equals to VR cos hyperbolic gamma x plus IR ZC sin hyperbolic gamma x. And this is equation number 10. Now, I equals to 1 by zc into vr into under bracket e to the power gamma x minus e to the power minus of gamma x by 2 plus ir zc into under bracket e to the power gamma x plus e to the power minus of gamma x by 2. So that is equals to 1 by zc into under bracket vr sin hyperbolic gamma x plus ir zc cos hyperbolic gamma x. Therefore, I equals to VR by ZC into sin hyperbolic gamma x plus IR cos hyperbolic gamma x. That is equation number 11. Now, the rewriting the equations x equals to L where Vs equals V equals to Vs and I equals to Is, we get Vs equals to VR cos hyperbolic gamma x plus IR ZC sin hyperbolic gamma x, that is equation number 12. There and IS equals to VR by ZC sin hyperbolic gamma L plus IR cos hyperbolic gamma L, that is equation number 13. Now these two equation relates the sending end voltage and the current when the receiving end quantities. Now, comparing the equation 12 and 13 with the general voltage and the current equation of the line, we have A equals to cos gamma x, B equals to ZC sin hyperbolic gamma L, A equals to cos gamma L, B equals to ZC sin hyperbolic gamma L, C equals to 1 by ZC sin hyperbolic gamma L and D equals to cos hyperbolic gamma L. So from this it is clear that A equals to D equals to cos hyperbolic gamma L, and that means AD minus BC equals to cos e square gamma l minus zc sin hyperbolic gamma l minus in sorry into 1 by zc sin hyperbolic gamma l, and that is equals to 1. So these are the expressions for long transmission line. Now a problem: a 3-phase 50 hertz 500 kilometer long transmission line has the following line constant per phase per kilometer uniformly distributed, that is R equals to 0.44 ohm, X equals to 0.9 ohm, G equals to 8 into 10 to the power minus 9 mho, and B equals to 5.06 into 10 to the power minus 6 mho. Now determine the line constant by using convergent series of the complex angles. Now the solution: the resistance per phase in kilometer R equals to 0.44, impedance per phase per kilometer Z equals to R plus Jx, where X is the reactance per phase in kilometer, that is equals to 0.9. So Z equals to R plus Jx, and that is equals to 0.44 plus J 0.9 ohm. Conductance per phase per kilometer G equals to 8 into 10 to the power minus mho. Susceptance per phase per kilometer B equals to 5.06 into 10 to the power minus 6 mho. Admittance per phase in kilometer Y equals to 0.008 plus J 5.06 into 10 to the power minus 6 mho. Line length L equals to 500 kilometer. Now the total series impedance Z equals to 0.44 plus J09 into 500. So this equals to 220 plus J450 ohms. Now the polar form of this equation is 500.9 angle 69.95 degree ohms. Now the total shunt admittance Y equals to 0.008 plus J5.06 into 10 to the power minus 6 into 500. And this equals to 0.004 plus J2.53 into 10 to the power minus 3 mho. And the polar form of the expression is 2.53 into 10 to the power minus 3 angle 89.91 degree mho. Hence, YZ equals to 2.53 into 10 to the power minus 3 of angle 89.91 degree into 500.9 angle 63.95 degree. And if we solve the expression, then the answer is 1.2673 of an angle 153.86 degree. And the rectangular form of this angle is angle, and this expression is minus of 1.1376 plus J0.5583. Similarly, Y square Z square equals to 1.2673 square into an angle 307.22 degree. And the rectangular form of this angle is 0.9826 minus J1.27. And for the same way, Y3Z3 equals to 1.2673 cube at an angle 461.58 degree, and the rectangular form is minus of 0.408 plus J1.9938. Now, using convergent series of the complex angle, A equals to D equals to 1 plus YZ by 2 plus Y square Z square by 2 to the power by 24 plus Y cube Z cube divided by 720, neglecting all the other terms. So If we put in the value of these parameters, then the equation is A equals to D equals to 1 plus minus of 1.1376 plus J0.5583 divided by 2 plus 0.9826 plus J1.27 divided by 224, and the value of Y3Z3 by 720 is 0 minus of 0.408 plus J1.9938 divided by 720. So if we solve the calculation, then the answer is 0.4716 plus J0.2291 ohm, and that is equals to 0.524 at an angle 25.9 degree ohms. So similarly, B equals to Z into under bracket 1 plus YZ divided by 6 plus Y square Z square by 120 plus Y cube Z cube divided by 5040 ohms. Here also neglecting all the terms, then if we put in the value of these parameters, all the parameters, then the equation is like that: 220 plus J450 into 0.81842 plus J0.08287 ohms, and that is equals to 412.04 at an angle 69.73 degree, and the rectangular form of this is like 142.57 plus J386.52 ohms. Similarly, C equals to Y into under bracket 1 plus YZ by 6 plus Y square Z square by 120 plus Y cube Z cube by 5040 mu. Here also neglecting all the terms, then the if we put in the value of all the parameters, then the equation is C equals to 2.53 into 10 to the power minus 3 under bracket 89.91 degree into 0.8226 at an angle 5.78 degree, and the solution is 2.08 into 10 to the power 3 at an angle 95.69 degree, and the polar form is minus 0.0002 plus J0.00207 mole.